In 1974, a menacing helicopter took to the skies for the first time. It had one simple mission: survive, no matter the cost. Its designers built its hulking frame from lessons learned during the Vietnam War, chief among them being that a helicopter isn't any good if it can't stay in the fight. This new helicopter, more of a flying tank than your average helicopter of the era, would go on to serve 40 years with the U.S. military, and it's still got several more decades left in the tank. Meet the UH-60 Blackhawk. The U.S. Army's main helicopter during the Vietnam War, the UH-1 Iroquois, served admirably but proved too vulnerable when landing in combat zones. More than 7,000 total UH-1s served in Vietnam, but more than 3,300 of them were ultimately shot down or destroyed, killing 2,100 pilots and crew members. The Army needed a better solution. It needed a helicopter that could deliver troops where they needed to go, but also withstand the brutalities of combat in order to complete its mission. After a fierce competition, including an upgraded version of the Huey transport, Sikorsky won the day with a helicopter that was purpose-built to do one thing: survive. Self-sealing, crash-capable fuel tanks protected against small arms fire and hard landings. Tail rotor blades were made out of ballistically resilient materials. The main rotors were equally resilient, and the armored cockpit increased pilot survivability. Along with redundant systems so the helicopter could remain airborne after taking fire, the UH-60 was quite the heavyweight, but its two engines and four-blade propeller, which could lift 8,000 pounds and still cruise away at 100 miles per hour, made the aircraft surprisingly nimble. It wouldn't take long for the Blackhawk to prove this work. It was involved in the invasion of Grenada in 1983, the invasion of Panama in 1989, and played a big role in the Gulf War, where it participated in the largest air assault in U.S. Army history, when more than 300 helicopters, including Blackhawks and AH-64 Apaches, attacked Saddam Hussein's forces. It wouldn't take long for several variants to arrive, offering different capabilities across the armed forces. The SH-60 Seahawk could operate off Navy helicopter or aircraft carriers. The Firehawk came equipped with a 1,000-gallon water tank mounted below the fuselage, a perfect aircraft for fighting wildfires. And the VH-60N White Hawk, a transport variant for the U.S. Marine Corps, is better known as Marine One when the President is on board. The Blackhawk fought on battlefields across the world and was famously depicted in 2001's Black Hawk Down, a film based on the real events that occurred in Mogadishu, Somalia in 1993. A mysterious stealth variant of the Black Hawk also played a central role in Operation Neptune Spear, the 2011 mission that successfully killed al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden. The helicopter's transport ability, along with its firepower, Hellfire missiles, the FIM-92 Stinger missile, a six-barreled minigun, and a variety of machine guns, has created a winning combination. Today, the U.S. military owns and operates more Black Hawks than any other air or rotorcraft, with more than 2,100 of them in service. Although there are plans to retire the Black Hawk in favor of a more modern replacement, the Army has made it clear that it expects these highly capable medium-lift helicopters to remain in service through 2054, some 75 years after their introduction. For a helicopter that's built to survive, it's a fitting legacy.